Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes Song of the Ocean. I am Amethyst Lunatari, now heading to Ekyul. The second biggest city in this world, I guess. Monster's still afraid. Well, you're blocking the way. There you go. Any special chest around? Yes! Yay! We got a red bandana. Like Grandpa Lap had. Before he was a grandpa. Is that... I guess that's an accessory? Yeah. Bandana of sharp red color. Refreshes your mind, increasing your attack power. Well, Ada can have that. Oh, that one. Attack up by 6 and defense by 2. Oh, okay. Gonna have to fight you now. Flying squirrel and runner wolf. Everyone pile on the squirrel! Forget which button you press for this again. Get that squirrel! Shining arrow, go! Missed. Should I save my others? Yeah, I think we'll save it. We're taking down these wolves pretty easily. And they're missing half the time. Forte! Level 18, Jan and Rick as well. Ada barely moving because she's already level 22. it's nice to fight something once in a while. I don't know why we're like eternally over-leveled, it seems. It's nice to give my voice a break a little bit. what's this way? Oh, or this way. That's where we came from, right? Alright, so we ran this way. Went here. this just goes a loop-to-loop around, and okay, we're continuing this way. Right? No? Where do we come from this? I don't even know anymore. Which way do we come from? I kind of got turned around. There's very little monsters here. Yeah, it came from here. Alright. Let's just try to concentrate here. Come down here. This is... Oh. Is this a special rock wall thing? No, right? It looked funny. Alright, now we're coming down this way. All linear. So here we have a choice to go this way or down. And this is the loop-to-loop. Wait, so how do we... I guess we're supposed to go this way then. But this is a different way? I'm not just going back? I'm not completely sure. Maybe we're on the right track, because I don't remember seeing that. Oh, you want to fight now? Alright. Should go south next. Really surprising. We saw it right there. Interrupt. Hope this is not going back to the village we just came from. That's nothing. I have no idea. Are you kidding? Okay, well, I don't remember seeing all these loop-to-loops. Okay, that's a way off the screen. So, yeah, I think we're on a new area. I think. There's nothing here. There's a lot of these, roundabouts, I guess you'd call them. Sleeping? Well, far be it from me to disturb your slumber. Can we get past you? Nope. This all looks so familiar though. It's kind of maze-like right now. Dog, what's it called? Dog charge? No. Charge dog. I had it back. Charge dog! Kill. Oh, I didn't kill it. Surprised. Good. Finished them off. I like it. Okay. Big open area. Oh, with nothing. Hey, Ekyul, cool. I didn't think we'd seen another big city so soon, but we are. Forte says, it's a pretty big city. Not as big as Kavara, though, says Aina. Yes, that's what we heard. Ekyul. Alright, so we're gonna look all over, of course. No. Not necessary. Okay, we got ye old weapon shoppy here. Same sword. We got slender sword, which raises Forte's attack by 7. Huh. Who would use a condor dagger? Is someone else gonna join? So the slender sword is a long sword with a thin, flexible blade, good for piercing rather than swinging. Hmm. Condor dagger. Dagger with flight blade. Hunts down its prey like a condor. Mm. He's throwing daggers. Dagger with a twisted blade for the hurricane dagger. Spins like a storm and severs with a light contact. Then we have Ada's flash spear. Oh, new intercept spear. So we just bought her a new spear and she got another one already. Intercept spear, which will raise her attack by 8. And her defense by 1. Spear with steel handle and spindle-like thin tip. Strong and deadly for veterans. Okay, the U-bow and a new sniper bow for Una. Bow reinforced. We can buy all this stuff, can't we? Bow reinforced with several lumber pieces. Very accurate. Can pierce through a coin. Wow. Fighter glove is McBain's and a new tiger glove for McBain. Steel claws are embedded in impact area. A reliable weapon in experienced hands. Here's a shark hammer. Hammer with pointed impact area. I'm talking about impact area. With experience, you can even dent an armor. Flail hammer. Hammer with iron blocks tied to a chain. Its impact area catches enemies off guard. It's more like a... Yeah, it is a flail. It's a flail and a hammer together. That's pretty cool. Medium shield. Kite shield. Raise Forte's defense by a whole 1. Diamond shield that looks like a cat. Kite. Ideal for dodging the enemy's attack. And there's the chest guard that we have in ring armor for Forte, which raises his defense by 5. Armor with iron rings sewn to leather. Affordable and widely used. Alright, well let's exchange our gents, and we can't buy that much. I mean, of course we're going to sell things back, maybe we can buy one extra thing. This is 2,800 gents for the slender sword. ...2,800 for the intercept spear. Same for the sniper bow. Tiger glove. Everything's 2,800. Except for the kite shield, which is 350. And the ring armor, which is 1,400. Let's buy the shield. And the armor. And we'll buy the slender sword. And let's see if we can get something else. All for Forte, I know. Seems rather unfair. But... it don't matter. Kite shield. Up by 1. And... Slender Sword, attack up by 7. And Air Armor to Ring Armor, attack up by 2. Now, just curious. I don't think anyone else uses shields, do they? No. Alright. So we're selling his shield. Maybe the air armor for McBain, that would bring him up by 11 points. Or for Una, that would bring her up 18 points, but her avoidance goes down by 10. I don't know if I like that. Does his avoidance go down? No. Alright, so far we're giving the air armor to McBain. And only up by 3 for Ada, so yeah, that's for McBain then. Alright, now he's wearing the air armor. And what about the rivet armor for... Brings her up by 7, but her avoidance down by 10. I don't know if that's worth it. I mean, I don't know if defense is more important than avoidance. I mean, it might be. It's higher up, and it seems like a standard thing. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if that's worth doing. To bring her avoidance down like that. I think it's Ada down, okay. So we're gonna sell the rivet armor, and the medium shield, and the sword. I equipped that on him, right? Slender sword. So I have another slender sword? Oh, that's I'm in buy, aren't I? Yeah, I don't want to be doing that. Rivet armor. 300. Medium shield, 140. Severing sword, 1100. People are thieves. Thieves, I tell you! We're gonna have to kill some monsters to, like, grind for money. Oh, 2800. Wait. Everything's 2800. Look at that. I'm 16 gents short. No, 18. 18 gents short. I'll sell something. See if I don't. I guess that would be good for grinding. HP restored completely. I'm keeping that. Water ball, fireball, marbles. What's the tarp do? Oh. Yeah, we need a lot of this stuff. But maybe I can sell some marbles just to get enough. I don't use them anyway. I mean, maybe I should, but... 7 gents. And 7 gents. And 5 gents. So if I... sell them. I mean, we got them a while ago anyway. Who knows how strong they are. So that's 14... 19. That'll be just enough, won't it? Oh, I have more than one. You know what? Let's keep 2 of them. Let's keep two of these. And we just have two. Alright, we can buy another thing now. I'm not getting daggers, for people that don't need them. Intercept spear for Ada. That's pretty good. Or the sniper bow for Una. Or the tiger glove for McBean. I'm gonna go with the tiger glove for now. Alright. Attack up by 8, defense by 1. He'd be kicking butt now. So let's just sell the other glove. And then we'll have to try to figure out. I mean, oh, you can sell it for that much? That's pretty... not bad, actually. Alright, so we just need a little bit more money, and then we can buy the other stuff. The bow and the spear. Alright? That's all we need, a bow and a spear. Alright, the intercept spear and the sniper bow. Okay. I'll work on getting that done. When we're done exploring the city. What's in here? Oh, that's a door? Oh. It's locked. Yes. Let's pick the lock. No excuse, it's locked. You give up. Look, there's stairs down and everything. Just checking out all the east side of town here. All these rooms. Wait. Oh, there's people in there. Oh, I never realized there was a door here. A doorway, rather. Desert Trader says, Ada, how's Cavaro? Not good. I don't think we can enter there because the numerous soldiers are still staying there. Really? That's not good. I came all the way to carry specialty goods from Ostern. Since I came this far, I would love to do business in Cavaro. Yes, you would love. Manon says, Ada, you went to Marcha alone? You shouldn't do that. It's too dangerous. Don't worry. I'm pretty good at using a spear. I can handle a marionette much better, though. Watching Ada makes me nervous. Don't make your grandpa worry, okay? Bartender? Hi, Ada. How is Marcha? I'm so upset. The wood soldiers appeared in Marcha. I was this close to being blamed for it. That's too bad. There are simple-minded people who dare to think that it was Rosette's deed because the wood soldiers did it. Indeed. Oh, didn't mean to hit it again. These rooms are empty. How dare they? They're supposed to be filled with precious loot. Alright. That's a pretty big inn. Oh wow. Got all that. Let's just see whatever is around here. Here's the armor shop, which probably can't afford anything here either. Well, that's the weapon shop, never mind. Where we've already been. That's a locked place. It's very offensive to me. Giraffe is south. Huh. Giraffe. prefer the Hippo Town. Alright, item shop. He's got all the standard stuff. I don't need any of it. Do not require it. Hoi. Kareever says, "Hey Ada, I heard you went to Marcha. Don't make Grandpa Rosette worry too much." "No, my grandpa asked me to." "Really? I didn't know that." But then he repeats himself anyway. "Hi, Ada. It's rare to see you with customers. They are not here to buy Grandpa's dolls. They are his friends. I hope you have a good time here," Natera says. "Thank you," says McBean. "Thank you, thank you." Alright. Books? Nope. Okay. Tabby says, "Ada, play with me." The little girl is holding a teddy bear. "Bang Bang wants to play with you, too." "Sorry, but not today, okay?" says Ada. "You're mean." "Alright then, I'm gonna play with Bang Bang. Right, Mr. Bang Bang?" So formal. Any secrets in the walls here? Look, we were seeing them for a while, but then they stopped, right? Or was that Tear of a Million that had all those secrets in the walls? I'm kind of getting them mixed up sometimes. Alright, let's see the rest of this. Oh, that's the little girl. That's Tabby. Checkpoint is west. Ada says, "Hey, why don't you stop by my house? Otherwise my grandpa will be sad. Mr. Mac, do you remember where my house is?" "Don't talk to me like I'm senile. I'm not old enough to forget where the Rosette's workshop is." "If you say so," says Forte, "but you're not so confident, are you?" A little. "It's been over 10 years since you came here last, right?" says Una. "You can't really help it." "Well, Rosette's workshop is go north from the center of Ekyul," says Ada. "It will come back to you once you start walking, I'm sure." "Okay, let's go," says Forte. That's why I do stuff like this, like try to leave town. It was this whole dialogue here. I mean, I knew we wouldn't be able to. Just wanted to see what would happen. And I was not disappointed. What's this place? Corks says, "Hi, Ada. I didn't see you for a while. Where have you been?" "I went to Marcha to order some yarns." Quark says, "I hear that wood soldiers are giving them a hard time over there, right? You have a lot of guts, as usual." "Wood soldiers mean nothing," she says. "I'll just run them through with a spear." "Grandpa Rosette is a lucky guy to have a granddaughter like you, Ada." Clam. Quarks and Clam. "Ah, Ada? Hi, Clam. I don't like you. Go away." "Oh, you're so loveless," she says. "Is that the right attitude to have towards your kind neighbor?" "What are you talking about? You spanked my butt as hard as you could just because I went out to play a little too far." "Haha, it was just tough love." "You're a meanie, Ada. Do you want to be spanked again?" Maybe he's into it. Mel says, "The other day my brother went too far to play, and Ada had to go get him. He got a good spank later. He deserved it, though." "Yeah, we've heard about this." "Compared to your brother, you never gave me a hard time," says Ada. "Good girl." Ada patted the girl on her head. "Ha ha ha," she says, "I'm a good girl." "Who's a good girl?" What else is here? Is this the workshop? Maybe not. The mayor's wife says, "Hi, Ada. Did you see my husband at your factory?" "Huh? Is the mayor at my house?" "He went to your house because he wanted to see the new marionette ahead of everyone else." "Anyone else?" "You mean Kapuri," says Ada. "By the way, who are these people?" McBain says, "We're the McBain Company, a group of troubadours. I think I met Mayor Holstow at Rio Tom Island. It's good to hear that he's well." "Oh, you're the McBain Company. I've heard about you from my husband. Thank you for your help on that occasion." The mayor's wife bowed her head deeply. "Oh, nice. Hmm? Mr. Mac? What happened on Rio Tom Island?" "Nothing big." The wife says, "My husband has been noticing the shadow of the numerous empire near this town, so he's very worried. Please help him if you can." If we can. And look out the window. There, now we're looking out the window. I feel so accomplished. Oh, I just wanted to line him up so he's looking out. Alright, go around. Nobody wandering around or anything going on. This is where I've been. Right? She's in there? Okay. Yeah, I went in all these places. Alright, never mind. Kind of tricky because they look samey sometimes. So where's this... Right, over here. Interesting. Balkus the fisherman says, "Freshly caught fish! Flopping fish! You're working hard," says Ada. "Hi, Ada. How do you like the fish for dinner? I just caught it." "Wow, it just flopped." "It's fresh fish just loaded at the fishing village in Giraffe. You can cook or broil it. Or you can even make sashimi. Yay, it's very fresh. I love sashimi." That's interesting. Does it go anywhere different, though? That's the question. It just goes out here. There's the item shop. So we've got this way, that way, that way. We came in... this way or that way, doesn't matter. Who's that? Oh, that's the item shop guy. Oh, so what's the point of this whole center here? And these columns. There's four columns. Where's the item shop? Oh, not the workshop again? Let's try to leave town and see what they say. Go north from the center of Ekyul. Okay. Maybe it is that hard to find that they just had to give us that little hint. So I'm guessing this is center of Ekyul, north. Going north. Is it a separate area? Oh, north is Rosette's workshop. It's not even in the city. I thought it was in the city. So we really explored the whole city? You're right, it is smaller than Cavaro. Why, here's the inn again. Alright, never mind. Unless, it's considered part of the city, actually. No, it's a totally different area. It's really like a big village. What's a dead end? Wait here, says Ada. Why? Una asks. I want to surprise my grandpa. When I call you, appear, saying, ta-da! Ta-da! Alright, says Forte. We're very agreeable people. We'll just go along with anything. I'm back, says Ada. Rosette says, hey, you're back. It's what she said, isn't it? Mayor Holsto says, Ada, welcome home. Ah, Mayor. Mayor says, did you go to Marcha alone? It's dangerous because of the monsters. Aren't you worried to let her go alone? Rosette says, she's fine. She'll zap the monsters that appear along the road. Right. I had encouraging support on the way home, too. But she's higher level than all of us, so she's fine. Support, says Rosette. Yes, support. You'll be surprised, Grandpa. Come in, please.